Hello everyone, I'm Brett Berry and welcome back to Math Hacks. Today I am going to show you the tricks that I use to simplify cube roots by hand. Now, cube roots can be a little bit trickier than square roots to simplify, so we're going to run through a few examples and I'm going to show you a couple different ways you can approach those problems. When working with cube roots, it's going to be a lot like working with square roots to simplify. The only difference is that instead of looking for perfect square factors in your radicand, you're looking for perfect cube factors. So those are numbers like 8, 27, 64, 125, and so on. For this first problem, we're trying to take the cube root of 16. Now I know that 8 is a factor of 16, so I'm going to start by splitting 16 up into 8 times 2. Again, just like in square roots, we can separate this cube root into multiple cube roots, one for each factor. Doing that is a really handy step because it helps us see that when we take the cube root of 8, which is 2, it breaks free of the radical. So my answer becomes 2 cube root 2. In this second problem, we are going to reduce the cube root of 15 times the cube root of 9. Now when you first look at this problem, you probably think it can't be reduced because the only perfect cube that is useful for us to reduce that is smaller than 15 or 9 is 8, and 8 is obviously not a factor of either of these numbers. But the trick here is that when I multiply these two together, their product makes a number that is reducible. So the first thing I'm going to do is just combine these into one cube root. And instead of multiplying these out, I'm just going to use a little factor tree to help me simplify this. I'm going to make factor trees for both 15 and 9. And I know that the product of those two factor trees will be the product of their prime factorizations. And because I got a cube number in my prime factorization, I know that I can reduce this cube root because a cube and a power of 3 are inverses of each other. So I'm just going to replace 15 times 9 with the prime factorization of 3 cubed times 5. Like in the last problem, I'm going to split this apart into two separate roots. And lastly, the cube and the cube root cancel each other out, so I'm just left with 3 on the outside, so my answer will be 3 cube root 5. For this problem, it's not really obvious if there are any perfect cube factors that go into 192, because 192 is sort of a large number. My go-to trick for this is to always, always, always make a factor tree, and when working with the exponents, it's a little bit clearer to see what reduces. So here I found that the prime factorization of 192 is 2 to the 6 times 3. So I'm just going to go ahead and replace 192 with its equivalent prime factorization. Just like we've been doing in the previous problems, I'm going to split this into separate cube roots. And to make it a little bit easier in the next step, I'm going to break out every group of 3 that I can. So that means I'm going to split 2 to the 6th power into 2 cubed times 2 cubed, and you'll see in the next step how easily we can simplify this problem when we do that. Now I'm free to go ahead and cancel out the cubes with the cube roots. So that leaves me with 2 times 2 times the cube root of 3, and there's nothing else I can do to simplify, so all I need to do here is go ahead and find the product of 2 times 2 and write our answer. The last thing I want to show you today is just how to use the alternate fraction notation to simplify these problems, because in some roots, especially higher order index roots, the fraction notation can be a really nice way to simplify roots. So instead of going from the cube root of 2 to the 6 times 3 and breaking it into separate cube roots, let's go ahead and trade out the cube root for a power of 1/3. If you're new to fractional exponents, I recommend checking out my other lesson on fractional exponents where I go in depth about how to work with them, especially in the context of radicals. So in this step, what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to apply my exponent rules. So I'm going to raise 2 to the 6th power to the 1/3 power, and I'm also going to raise 3 to the 1/3 power. Since I had a power on the 6th already, I just added parentheses around it so that I could raise it to the 1/3 power. Now my rule here is to multiply 6 and 1/3 together, which gives me 2. And for this one, because I can't simplify it any further, I'm just going to reintroduce the cube root back in. Lastly, I just multiply out 2 squared to get our answer of 4 cube root 3, which was the same as we got up here. So you could use either notation, it's entirely up to you. And sometimes these fractions are just a really nice way to tackle a hard problem. I really love breaking down those large numbers into their prime factorizations, because once you find the prime components of a number, it just makes everything so much simpler. There are so many things you can do once you find that prime factorization, and simplifying cube roots is just the tip of the iceberg. If you'd like notes and some practice problems on this topic, check out the description box below where I have linked a special little PDF for you. And as always, I really, really appreciate it when you give me a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any more math hacks in your feed. Till next time, I'm Brett Berry, and this has been Math Hacks.